What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to J-Box Studios, your home for reviews, reactions, and ridiculousness. Anyways, guess what? We're jumping back over to the Netflix machine for a movie that's actually a little bit early, an early screener that's coming out actually next week for all of you guys and the gals out there. But I was able to check out the new film, I'm Thinking of Ending Things. Full of misgivings, a young woman travels with her new boyfriend to his parents' secluded farm, all while evaluating their relationship. So is this new Netflix movie one hell of a weird and wild trip? Let's find out. But before I get into my thoughts, let me know what you guys are thinking of this movie, if you've seen the trailer or read the source material that it's based on, or if you're very much looking forward to this new Netflix movie. Now let's get into some of the good. I am so excited to finally be able to talk about I'm Thinking of Ending Things, because this movie was an experience. This movie, I'm going to use the B word that I usually use, and this movie was bonkers. No lie, this is about 2 hours and 15 minutes of me audibly saying, what the f*** is going on, but loving every single second of it. It was a trip of a movie. Now, getting into actually why it was such a trip of a movie and everything is that this is from director and screenwriter Charlie Kaufman. And if anyone out there is familiar with his work, Eternal Sunshine of a Spotless Mind, Being John Malkovich, and a few other projects here or there, this guy is into weird stories or doing a lot of weird aspects and world building in his movies. And I'm Thinking of Ending Things. Mind you, it is adapted from the source material, a book by the same name. I am kind of under the understanding that he took a few things from the book and kind of did his own thing in this movie. But like I mentioned, those two other movies and the Charlie Kaufman flavor is all throughout this movie. Like, this movie is, again, going back to that B word, absolutely bonkers. But the thing is, Kaufman is able to craft it in such a unique way, using these artistical choices that honestly feel so completely outlandish, but drew me into the movie even more. I was emotionally invested in these characters, what was happening, the weird things on the screen that completely come out of nowhere. Like I said, this guy is able to put these artistical choices in this movie, such as a musical, such as like these weird time-changing elements, almost like a drug trip at times, and an interpretive dance scene that literally brought me to tears. I was, like I said, emotionally invested in this movie because of just how engaging it was. I wanted to know what these characters were up to, where their story was going to end, and what Kaufman did, the spin that he did, the style that he threw into this, kept me intrigued throughout this whole movie. And that's the thing, is not only did he choose to put these artistical choices, but the way that everything is filmed, from these quick cutaways to these almost split in time sequences of the camera quickly panning from something or something from the kind of point of view completely disappearing. It was, again, such a trip of a movie, and it was gorgeous to watch this. Like, I maybe am just sucking this movie off right now, but I cannot get over this experience that I had with this movie, because I don't think I've had an experience like this in probably 5 years. Like, this was, again, a wild movie experience. And then rounding it out, I mean, this had so many great things going for it. And the performances here are what tie everything together, because it is the confusion of the main characters that gets you confused and invested in the story, because it's kind of this relationship, boyfriend, girlfriend going to visiting the parents on the weekend. Jesse Buckley is playing the main woman, who is playing Lucy, and her boyfriend, Jesse Clemens, is playing Jake. And they do such a great job. It's like a 30-minute scene of them in the car. But the conversation, the dialogue, going back to the script and whoever Kaufman was responsible for doing this, making it such an intriguing dialogue bouncing back and forth and putting these kind of thoughts in someone's head of being able to kind of, you know, when you're sitting in a car and it's silent, what is going through those characters' minds? So the performances from these people, fantastic. Like I said, Jesse Buckley is by far probably the main character here. Jesse Clemens is close, but they have great chemistry, a great dynamic. They play so well off of each other in these very long, drawn-out dialogue scenes of a car or a dinner party and whatnot. And I'm not even touching on Toni Collette and David Thewlis, I believe, as the parents. Once we get to the house, even more crazy goes down. I'm sorry, I'm gonna swear here, but the performances honestly explain or almost reinforce why there's such crazy, unsettling, what is going on in this movie, and it works again with everything Kaufmel does here. However, I am not gonna sit here and suck this movie to completion, because you know what? This movie makes no sense. This movie is insane. If anyone, any casual fan sits down and watches this and you make them write an essay, they won't know what the hell they're talking about. There will be thousands of interpretations. And I think that that is the main thing. The biggest negative, almost con in my eyes, is I haven't a damn clue what this movie is about. And that honestly maybe ties in with the experience. Maybe that's why this movie was so special, because I was sitting there for the 2 hours plus trying to figure out what the hell is going on. But the thing is, I guess from the book, the source material, there's a concrete answer of what is going on. My understanding is that they did not transform that into a source material, into a visual art that makes sense. Like I said, artistical choices in this, a lot of weird stuff. I'm thinking of ending things almost hits at this weird crossroads of I loved it to goddamn insanity and nonsense. Overall, I'm thinking of ending things is one hell of a fantastical head trip that maybe I liked, maybe I didn't like. With it featuring the artistical and almost insanity aspects of Kaufman, with great performances and beautiful artistical shooting and something that just really drew you into this film. But the one big negative is not having a damn clue what this movie is about. I would honestly recommend checking out I'm Thinking of Ending Things, purely because of the experience I had with this movie. The experience I had with this was such an enthralling, engaging, what the hell is going on, me trying to figure out, put these pieces together into the end, literally the last second of the movie. It still kept me engaged in I'm Thinking of Ending Things. In closing, I'm going to give I'm Thinking of Ending Things 4.5 out of 5. What the f***? So what did you guys think of I'm Thinking of Ending Things? If you've already seen this movie, looking forward to this movie, have seen this movie and are thoroughly confused, or even read the book, I'm curious. Let me know in the comments down below. Anyways though, believe me, I will be doing a very extensive ending explained poorly for this video. Stay tuned for all of that. Otherwise, as always, thank you so much for watching. Watch some more videos up there or right over there. You know, brand new content every single week here on the JBox Studios channel. I don't know entirely what exactly is coming this weekend or next week, but stay tuned, believe me, for that ending explained poorly, because my God, there's a lot to explain. Otherwise, follow all of my social media down there. Like this video, subscribe to the JBox Studios channel, and until next time, honestly, I have no idea.